Shalom, Kahala Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shah, Bahasham, Rakakwadash, the bonus to the apostles and others, a great millstone, peace and blessings. Certain parts of the globe, you know, mainly here in Babylon, other parts of the globe, will be hit by some of the destruction, but, you know, Earth itself is not going to be destroyed. Alright, we're going to get out of the position to the point, you know. Hopefully, we had a plan, but with that, I'm going to start with 2 Peter 3. Also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up. All right, basically everything, you know, is gonna be completely laid to waste now. All right, Babylon, great, America, all right, gonna be completely destroyed. You know, you won't know what state begins or ends, man. All right, it's gonna become a wasteland. Thank you. those of us that are, you know, pretty much, you know, following out, watching out shot, you know, sighing and crying, you know, waiting for this, transition to take place, man. Okay, transition. This kingdom being destroyed, and our kingdom being established, man. Where we can truly live, all right, as a nation of people, man. All right, being so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, all right, that make up the tribes of Israel. All right, it said that we're living according to His promise. Look for new heavens and a new earth, where they dwell in righteousness. All right, so basically, you know, it's the point, man. For the end of this age, okay, and the establishment of the Lord kingdom, man. All right, you know, the earth itself is not going to be destroyed, you know, a certain part are going to be, you know, mainly America or Babylon.
Memphis.
Pretty much, you know, as a wasteland, all right. And real quick, this is 2 Ezra 6. I said, what shall be the parting asunder of the time? And what shall be the end of the place and the beginning of it, and he said, Abraham went to Isaac, and Jacob and Esau were born of him. Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau.
That follow it, all right. So his kingdom, his rule is gonna come to an end, and Jacob, you know, Israel, Yahshua, all right.
On the point of the earth abiding forever. All right, this is Ecclesiastes 1:4. Pretty much, takes it in a straight point. It's like that. It says Ecclesiastes 1:4. One generation passes away, and the other, and another generation comes. But the earth abides forever. So there it is, like that. All right. You know, yeah, stop. He says, blessed is Yahweh, oh my soul, oh Yahweh, my power. Thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty. Who covereth thyself with light as with a garment? Who stretches out the heart that philosophy? Who stretches out the heavens like a curtain? Who led the beams of his chambers in the water? Who maketh the clouds his chariot? Who walketh upon the wings of the wind? Who maketh his angels spirit and his ministers a flaming fire? Who laid the foundation of the earth that it should not be removed forever? You know? Right. Who laid the foundations of the earth that it should not be removed forever? All right. Right. Scripture, you know, clearly, you know, tells us that the earth, you know, is not going to grow and be destroyed. Right.